Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand up for the new Mr. and Mrs. Lopez Pereira. Okay guys, now we've got some story time. First up, I'd please like to call Tony, the father of the bride, who's come all the way from the UK to escape the chaos of Brexit, to come to what has certainly been a done deal. Please come up, Tony.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls,
although lots of girls,
many ladies but no girls, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to Haycroft Farm on the Midlands Meander next to Howick for the wedding reception of the new Mr. and Mrs. Lopez Pereira. So, everybody, welcome. It's just as well that the wedding ceremony today was in a forest, another church, because the last time Natalie and I were in the church, Natalie had to be escorted from the premises. She was two at the time. I knew from an early age that Natalie would one day make a fantastic wife for someone. By the way, she used to go to the fridge and get her daddy his kids. And come back with a big smile on her face. And she loved doing that. On the other hand, we have Sebastian. Now, I know for a fact that Sebastian will not make a good wife. But he will be the best husband as possible. I'm sure Natalie will see to that. The thing that gets me is, why did he take 12 years to ask Natalie to marry him? Don't you know a good thing when you see it? And I'm hoping that it doesn't take another 12 years to decide to have children. Because Natalie is no spring chicken. She's going to be pushing 50 by then. Anyway, I hope you've all got a bit of champagne in your glass, because I'd like to propose a toast. I need to get this bit right. I hope that you have 10 times more than whatever you could ever possibly wish for in your marriage together. So, to Sebastian and Natalie, may you have a great marriage. Thank you very much. Cheers, Natalie and Sebastian.
Next up, the bride's sister, Emily Bell. She's flown away from Abu Dhabi, left her students to memorize pi to 1,000 until she gets back. On it.
Okay, good evening, everybody. The poem that Dwight is about to say is very short, so please be with that. Okay, we're going to try our best. Okay. Good luck, congratulations.
Best wishes, well done.
The future's full of promise.
And it's only just begun.
You're starting on a journey.
A new exciting life.
Together as a partnership.
As husband.
And as wife.
Adventures, thrills, and choices.
Are waiting just for you.
The road will have some turnings.
Perhaps a bump or two.
But you'll be strong.
Together. You'll come through every test.
Your love will deepen.
Week by week.
We wish you all the best.
Marcus and Bianca. The gruesome twosome, Sebastian's favorite brother and sister. Dynamic duo. Come on, guys.
Bianca tried to do a speech together, but we thought we don't really work together too well, so I'm just going to go first and she'll go second.
We're too close in age.
Anyway, Sebastian and Nat, I can't believe today has finally come. Well done to you, bro, for finally putting a ring on it. Sheesh, you look beautiful, Nat. I know it doesn't need to be said, and it's been said all night, but seriously, you look stunning. And that smile's only intensified that beauty the whole day. Sebi, you're looking quite handsome yourself. And thank you very much for not choosing stripes or checkers, or both on this occasion. I'm not sure if you realize, but Seb doesn't always have the best dress sense. Best dress. He sort of decides to take his favorite top and pants, and it's always stripes with checkers, and he puts it together, and yeah, it doesn't go too well. So Nat, thank you for always making sure he's dressed well and making sure we look good tonight. Natalie, I still remember the first time meeting you 13 years ago now, when you fetched you in my father's Audi A8, black one or green one it was back then. And I was dropping you, Sebastian, and I'm pretty sure it was Kyle at a party. I didn't realize I was meeting my future sister-in-law in the back seat, squished there. However, since that day, you've always been like a big sister to myself and B. And I honestly cannot remember life without you in it. So look forward to all the memories with you more. And like many people, you two have managed to find each other at a young age and survive high school, long distance, living with me, university, and obviously as a couple. Instead of growing apart like many, you both have grown into such amazing individuals that complement each other so well, always backing each other to the very end. Living with you both in Cape Town allowed me to see firsthand what your relationship is really like. And to everyone in the room, it's actually just perfect. Wait, let me get this here a bit far. You support each other in ways, well, no one can imagine. You always support each other in your academics, social lives, and never once made me feel like an outcast or third wheel. Bro, like always, you're my big brother looking after me, making sure I was always okay, fed, always outed me to my mother by tidying my room, so I always had that in check. And you always invited me along with your mates. Nat, you always supported me in my decisions and provided great company constantly, especially with Chandler at your side. It was great living with you both, and this is why I know that you'll make an amazing couple, and that you are an amazing couple, and that one day you will make amazing parents. Having watched you both grow together, you have continued to show me what it is like to love and be loved. Your love is really rare, and I'm so happy and glad that you both managed to find your soulmates in each other. One love.
First, I'm going to start with saying, wow. It's amazing. I love being involved with decorations, and I've been studying, and I couldn't be involved. And I just want to say, Natalie and Sebastian, over the past few months, you've put every single thing together, from games to just the decorations, and I take my hat off to you. Well done. And then I'd like to start off with a few little words. A marriage is a promise that two hearts gladly make, a promise to be tender, to help, to give and to take. A marriage is a promise to be kind and understanding, to be thoughtful and considerate, fair and undemanding. A marriage is a promise to share one life together, a love-filled promise meant to be kept forever. Oops. My brother is the groom today, my big brother. Seb, biggest.
Wow.
I think I'm the favorite. Seb, I just want you to know how proud I am to stand with you as you wed the love of your life, the beautiful Natalie. You were our childhood playmate, our opponent, our confidant, and a friend. Well, especially when Marcus was running after me, probably harassing me, maybe spitting in my hair. You'd always have my back, and you'd always protect me, even sometimes with Stefan by your side. Here, I know Natalie has too found someone truly special with qualities such as these. However, you have chosen a bride and a sister for me, whom I admire greatly and respect so profoundly. When I was in grade 5 is when I first met Natalie. But before Natalie, I would always walk into Sebastian's room, mostly unannounced, probably irritating to him. But part of my favorite thing with him was to ask all the questions I could so I could try to know anything and everything that was going on in his life. I know how irritating, shame. Sorry, Sebastian. We had a little place there on his wall in his room where we would measure our height as we grew. And one day I read on the top of it, I saw a date. It was 21/04/2006, a date. Like, I was very confused. On our heart measure, I was like, a date, what for? So I asked, Seb, what is this date for? He saw where I was pointing, and I'm not sure if he wanted to tell me yet or if he knew how to. But he was quick to say, no, nothing. Attempting to hold back a smile, I realized this date symbolized something very, very special for him. Later on, I realized this was the date Sebastian had asked Natalie to be his girlfriend. Right there, you could see how head over heels he was without him even having to say anything. Me being the only girl, I think I found it difficult to share with a girl. But all the nights I spent with Nat and getting to know her really got me used to that. Natalie was always so kind to me, and always full of smiles, and would jump any day to help if I was down. Nats, thank you for being the light that you are. Please never stop. I really appreciate and am grateful for how you care for my brother, one of the most important people in my life. I hope and pray for us to continue to make such wonderful memories as a slightly bigger family, even though you were pretty much already family. May God bless you with a happy and joyous marriage, healthy lives, success, prosperity, and abundance. May your love keep growing and be the stuff even poets and authors dream of. Natalie, you've been a part of the family for long now, but welcome to the chaos. All the love to both of you as you are entering this journey. And on that note, can we all please raise our glasses as we celebrate the bride and groom? Cheers to Natalie and Sebastian.
There's a few guys who couldn't be here today. So we do have a very special message coming all the way from Australia for you, Seb and Natalie, from Luke de Vlieg. Please play that. Luke de Vlieg is Sebastian's cousin. They have a very close bond. Luke's always looked up to Sebastian. He sees you as a true role model, and he's got something to say to you.
Hey, Seb and Nat. Firstly, a massive congratulations on the long haul finally coming to a close. It's been an incredible journey for both of you to get to this point. So many ebbs and flows with distance at times, and all I can say is that I'm so inspired by the bond you two share. Seb, you've always been my big cousin that I look up to. I remember when I was young, I used to follow your every move because I thought you were the coolest person on earth. Maybe even went too far with the uncanny dating resemblance. But your relationship has epitomized resilience, partnership, and a true appreciation for love that can only be shared by a soulmate. It honestly breaks my heart that I'm not there to celebrate this day with you guys. But I pray that your journey together is packed with excitement and that your challenges will only bring you closer together, As Jesus says in Matthew 9, verse 6, since they are no longer two but one, let no one split apart what God has joined together. Embrace a journey, guys, and I hope that today is a day that you'll cherish for a lifetime. Sending over all my love.
Next up, we would have the best man, Travis Brooks, but he's busy flying around in Turkey. He unfortunately couldn't make it. He wished he could be here, and he sends his... You'll get your turn, cuz. He shed a tear during the ceremony. We all saw it. He really wishes he could be here. You thought you'd get off lightly that he's not here, but look at me. I'm the captain now, boy. I'm going to keep this brief. I think everyone's pretty keen to get fed. I'm just going to dive right into it, Sebastian. Everyone knows Sebastian's pretty well. He's got some pretty great qualities. But I presume that mind control is one that's pretty undercover, and I'll get to that a little bit later. He does have some other qualities, though. He's got a quality bike, quality jet ski, and now he's got a quality wife. Seeing as Travis, the best man, he did have some great things to say about you, but he's not here, so we'll wait until next time. I do know that he would love to be here though. He also said he's paying for the bar tab, so bottoms up, everyone. Have your drinks. Sebastian and Natalie have been together for around 13 years now. That is a long time. Probably much longer for Natalie, I'd imagine. Now, excuse me if some of the details are a little bit fuzzy, but I'm about to prove to you that Sebastian has supernatural powers. It was their first date. Sebastian has just spent the majority of the date money from his dad on cigarettes and clothes that did not match, like Marco said earlier. I actually had the same thing, which means it's true. Striped pants and checkered shirts and square toes just to round out the look. The gourmet dinner that he had promised Natalie was taking place at the Gateway McDonald's. And as I sat across from each other, Sebastian, with a mouthful of McDonald's chips, somehow managed to sweep Natalie off her feet, with a line that every girl wants to hear. I don't like to normally get tied down, so I don't like to ask girls out, but will you be my girlfriend? Natalie, if she's controlling you, give us a sign, blink, breathe, something. But all jokes aside, Sebastian truly is a great friend. You guys make the perfect couple, and it's so nice seeing you guys after 12 years just tying the knot and getting together. And I'd just like to raise a toast to you guys. Everyone could stand and raise their glasses. To a fulfilled and happy marriage. Cheers. Sebastian, you're getting your turn. Sebastian's up next. Now we all saw that speech that you scribbled down half an hour ago, so come on.
Jokes on you, I didn't write down a speech. It's times like this where it's actually very easy to speak from the heart. There's a lot of people here that are very close to me. Everyone here is someone that was chosen specifically to be here. No one's here by chance. I advise you to speak to someone new, learn something, make a new friend. Throughout my life, I've treated my friends as my friends, and my parents' friends as my friends. And I think that's worked for me. I've made good friends over all the ages, and I think age is just but a number. So feel free to mingle. I'd like to, first of all, say, babe, my wife, you are looking gorgeous.
Yes.
I was told to sit in a room back here, wait to be let in, and there was a whole lot of photos of other brides, and I was just thinking, shit, they got nothing on Natalie. There are some very special thanks, well, notes to make. Some people that traveled very far to be here. One of my groomsmen, Kyle, coming all the way from China. My China. Hey? And Marcus, sorry, obviously. You're my brother. It's like, it was just like, everyone knew it would have to happen. Let me start this side. I'm going to just go through everyone as I go around. So, family Danaha, thank you very much for coming all the way to be at our wedding. For those of you who don't know, family Danaha hosted me for 8 months after school, in my gap year. Ernst, the way we met was Ernst drove from Germany in his Unimog, which is now upgraded. I'm sure you didn't miss it on the way in. He just said to me, well, I think my mom was speaking to him and said, yeah, Sebastian's thinking about going to Germany and, you know, working there and seeing, maybe studying there. And he just opened up an invitation and said, well, come and work for me and stay with me. And it was definitely a tough choice to make, a tough choice to do that trip, especially seeing as it entailed a long-distance relationship with Natalie. And we got through it, and I'm very glad I did it. I made very awesome friends. I made a German sister. Where is she? Julia. My German sister. I'd like to say thanks as well to our German cousins and aunt, distant aunt, Carola and Valerie, for joining us. Also sitting down that side. All the way from Germany. I'm probably going to miss out a few people. Bettina, yes. 3 days of driving or something. Thank you so much for making us. We definitely are going to miss Jason, but we understand he wants to be here. George, for also coming all the way from Mozambique. George hosted me and Natalie and our family over the years at his place in Belen, George and Teresa hosted us, and that's where I proposed to Natalie. I've already caught flack from Teresa because she said, I can't believe the wedding, it hasn't been there. Thanks to all my mom's close friends, you guys mean a lot to me. Thanks to Alex and Alan doing the videography. It's cool having, you know, someone you know around. Oh, let me have a look around, see, make sure I haven't forgotten anyone. Phil, come on, boy. You're hiding me. All the way from Austria. Alex and Cheryl, all the way from London. I mean, that's amazing, guys. Thanks for coming. Kelsey, all the way from Cape Town. Matt and Amy, all the way from Joburg. Well, from Joburg. From Germany, it's not all the way anymore. Natalie's mom's friends. Please, guys, have a glass of wine with them. They drink their wines very well. All the way from England. Justin and Sade, yes. Tammy, thank you. See you, girl. Emily, all the way from Abu Dhabi. Obviously, Stefan already mentioned. And to anyone else I might have forgotten, you were noted. Just, Storm, I'm not going to mention you because you're such a needy person. Yes, of course. And yes, Tony, and you were right. I'm very sure I wouldn't make a good bride. I'm a bit proud of that. I know Tony was very happy with his intro song because it was the Liverpool song. Yes, please. One of the most... Okay, so when we got engaged, when we set a date, one of the most hardest things for me was to think of... Well, the only wishes that I had was that my Oma and Opa would make it, because I knew they were getting quite frail, put it that way. And unfortunately, my grandmother is suffering from Alzheimer's, so it hurts a little bit to know that she's not here. But I'm very glad to see my grandfather make it to my wedding. I think my opa is, to me, my role model. He's the man I look up to. He's the one who created our family, who started the family business, who got our family to where we are today, immigrating from World War II, if I'm not mistaken, or just after, coming seeking a better life. Yeah, actually, I'll come to that. I'd like to thank Vita for being here, my other grandmother. But she's got enough spunk left in her. She's going to be here for a while. I think she's going to outlive my dad, even. Thanks, Mom and Dad, for trying not to interfere too much with Natalie's plans. And yeah, I want to commend my wife on her great job. All the decorations were her ideas, her thoughts, her visions. I was only the tool she used to make them possible. I'd like to thank Paula and my parents and Tony financially to make this happen. You know what you did, and we appreciate it very much. Gives us a little bit more in our pockets to enjoy in Bali. So yeah, let's not carry on too long. Everyone, let's enjoy the bar. I think dinner's next. I'll let my MC carry on. He's being paid for a reason.
Not really.
He's getting paid in beer. No, wait, one person was missed. Esther has made a huge, huge, well, she put a lot of effort into this wedding. She's our local Durban designer. I don't know if any of you know, but she made all the bridesmaids' dresses. I think she made half of my family's dresses as well, or at least tailored half of them. And for that also we say thank you very much. And yeah, sorry. Yes, and Anna, for, like I said, I'm not going to get everyone. There was so much involved. The family just chip in. You don't ask them. They just throw things at you. It's like, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. You don't even have to ask. My godmother for helping with the decorations, coming up early. But yeah, sorry. Let's get back to drinking and eating.
Okay, guys. Are you ready? Let's start. All right, first question. Who dresses better? We'll start you. Oh, okay. Sebastian, yeah. Well, who is the better cook? Natalie's taking these.
That's an easy question.
Yeah, who's most likely to talk their way out of a speeding ticket? Out of a speeding ticket, Seb, not into a speeding ticket. Who is the bigger party animal?
Yeah. Nothing to think about.
Who is the better kisser?
That's you were quick on that one.
Who is most likely to cry during a sad film? Got the bigger alcohol problem. Yeah, I agree with Sebastian. I mean, look at all the wine that's on the table. Who's needier when they're sick? Who's better at directions? Who's the better dancer? Who is the most competitive? Oh, wow, okay. Yeah,
who's more likely to finish an argument? Seb generally starts them and finishes them. Who wears the pants in the relationship? Who spends more time staring at their cell phone? Last question. Who wants a baby first?